Saving the prisoner is not an easy task, but if you know the right algorithm, it will be cakewalk for you. Hey everyone, I am Kanhaiya Gupta and today I am gonna show you how to solve Save the Prisoner HackerRank problem. Guys, please go through the problem description once. Here I will just go through the input format. We have to complete the function Save the Prisoner. And that function accepts three parameters, n, an integer, the number of prisoners which is sitting around the round table, m, an integer, the number of sweets or candies which we are going to distribute, s, an integer, the chair number to begin passing out sweets with. Here s is the number from where we are start distributing the candies, and our task is to identify which prisoner will receive the last candy. Let's build the logic around it. So I've taken an example from the HackerRank platform itself. Here n equals to 7, which is the number of prisoner, m equals to 19, which is the number of candies which we are going to distribute, s equals to 2, which means we are going to start distributing the candies from the second prisoner. So let's see. So this is a round table, and here you can see all 7 prisoners are sitting. So now we are going to start distributing this 19 candies to them. For now, just ignore this value. It just tells from where we have to start the distribution. Currently, we are just considering a normal situation where we start distribution from the starting point onwards. So here, we are starting the distribution from first prisoners onwards. Now we have 19 candies. So we'll start distributing that from the first prisoner. And I'm denoting via C. So this is the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So this is the last candy, and the prisoner ID 5 or 5th received that candy. So in our case, answer is 5. So manually, we have to just distribute, and we can see 5 is the answer. But how we are going to tell the same thing to our program? Let's see. How we'll calculate how many candies each prisoner will get? It's very simple. We have to just divide 19 from 7. So 7 2 times is 14. Now remainder is 5. So you can see whatever the remainder is there, answer is also same, because quotient represent the 2 candies everybody will get. After that, we are left with the 5 candies which we have to distribute. So now we will start the counting from the first onwards. So the 5th one will receive the last candy. If we start the distribution always from first prisoner onwards, then remainder whatever we will get is the answer. But here comes the twist. We have given a S value here. So based on S value, it will shift. If we have taken a base value 1 from where we start the distribution, so the remainder will be our answer. But if S is given dynamically, in our case, we have given S equals to 2. So we will see how much the difference in our base value, whatever we have taken, and whatever we have to take. So you can see there's a 2 minus 1, 1 unit difference is there. It means whatever the answer we got right now, or whatever the prisoner is receiving the last candies, it will also shift 1 unit. If we start the distribution from the 2 onwards, then answer will be 6. If we start the distribution from 3 onwards, then how much is the difference? 1 and 3 minus 1, 2. So the answer will also shift 2 unit. So likewise, so here we have R remainder. First we'll calculate the remainder, which is M modulo N. So 19 modulo 7, which is equals to 5. If we have to always start from the 1, then remainder. So this is the formula we have to use, and we'll get the answer directly. But because we have a dynamic starting point, so in our case, we have to add this starting point, or we have to shift basically. Whatever the starting point is given, based on that, we have to shift our answer. So if what are the starting point is given, I am just adding that and subtracting 1. Why? Because 1 is our base which we have taken. So we have to take the relative shift, how much shift we are going to do. So if his starting position is 3, so we have to do 2 unit shift. So the answer will also shift 2 unit. So that's why we are adding the s and subtracting minus 1. Now suppose r is 5 in our case plus s is 7. They have given we have to start the distribution from 7 minus 1. So what we will get? 11, which is more than the number of prisoners, which is not a valid value. So that's why we have to take a mod of that. So now whatever the value will come, that will be our answer. So this is the final formula, which whatever it will give, that will be, that value will be our answer. Except one thing, as we know, we are doing a modulo operator. So this will always lies from between 0 to n minus 1. This value can never be n. So whenever we get 0, the value of this formula is equal to 0. It means there is no prisoner at all. Or we can say we have distributed all the candies equally to the all the prisoners, and the last prisoners will receive the last candy. So in our case, who is the last prisoner? N, because n is the number of prisoners. So in this case, n would be our answer. So based on that, we can write the logic something like this. If r plus s minus 1 modulo n equals to 0, in that case we are going to return n. Else we will return r plus s minus 1 modulo n. That's it. So this is what we have to do, guys. I hope you got this logic. Let's see the algorithm in action, guys. So here, this is the function. We are accepting 3 parameters, n, m, and s. First, we are calculating the remainder by using modulo operator. And after that, as we discussed, we are just checking whether remainder plus s, what is the start position, minus 1, because by default always starts from 1, so we are subtracting that and taking a modulo with n. If it's 0, we are returning n, else we are returning whatever will come. So this is a very simple approach, guys. We have used one formula. Now I'm trying to run the same thing in a HackerRank platform. Let me submit this code. So you can see all test cases got passed. If you have any doubt or any better approach, please let me know in the comment section. If you need the source code of this problem, you can go to the GitHub repository and download the source code from there. And the link is mentioned in the description box. I hope you like it, guys. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching, guys.